Which brand makes the best minimalist wallet? I spent almost $500 buying 15 different wallets to find out which is the best on the market today. If you're new to my Which Brand Makes the Best series, this is how it usually goes. I give a rating out of 10 based on different criteria, and at the end of the video, I tap all the scores to find out which brand is the winner. In this episode, I'll be rating each wallet based on its quality, its functionality, and overall value. At the end of this video, we'll find out which wallet takes the crown. So keep watching. The first wallet I have is from Ridge. This is in a gunmetal colorway and retails for $95. It weighs in at 62 grams and has a thickness of about 9 millimeters. This is made from 6061 aluminum, which has a yield strength of 45,000 psi. To put that in perspective, a brick has a yield strength of about 10,000 psi, so this wallet is over 4 times stronger than a brick. The design is extremely slim. It's literally the size of your credit card. How the wallet works, you simply slip in your cards between the two metal plates, and to access your cards, it has a cutout where you push with your thumb, and then you can pull your cards out. Even with this slim design, the elastic band can stretch out so you can hold up to 12 cards. Here's how the wallet looks in my pants. The slim design makes it barely noticeable and you can barely feel it. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it a 9. My only concern is that the elastic may stretch and wear out over time. For its functionality, I'll give it a 10. For its value, I'll give it a 6 because of its steep $95 price tag. That brings the total score to 25. Next wallet I have is from Simply Carbon Fiber. These are their cash and card slim wallet in forged carbon and regular carbon fiber. The forged carbon retails for $110 and the regular carbon fiber retails for $100. The forged carbon weighs in at 22 grams and the carbon fiber weighs in at 21 grams. Both have a thickness of about 11.95 millimeters. First impression, the wallet feels great in my hands. The carbon fiber does feel very high quality and extremely durable. The cool thing about this wallet is that this is made from a single piece of carbon fiber. Even the money clip is not a separate piece. There are no screws, no aluminum, just carbon fiber. And that is why this wallet is so light. How this wallet works, you can easily slip in your cards through here. You'll notice that there's a slight curvature at the edge, and that is so it's easier to slide your cards in. Very simple but very effective design. As you can see, this can easily hold up to 7 cards with no problem. At the back, there's a money clip. What you have to do is fold your bills in quarters and you can slide your cash through the money clip, and the clip is tight enough that you don't have to worry about your cash slipping out. Here's how it looks in my pockets. You can see a slight outline mostly because of the curvature of the money clip, but overall, the slim dimensions doesn't look bad at all. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it a 9. For its functionality, I'll give it a 9. For its value, I'll give it an 8. That brings the total score to 26, making this the highest rated wallet so far. Let's see if the next one can top this. Next two wallets I have are the Ekster Aluminum and Carbon Fiber wallets. This is in a brushed black colorway, and this one is carbon forged. The aluminum retails for $89, but it is on sale for $71. And the carbon fiber retails for $129, but it's on sale for $103. The aluminum weighs in at 79 grams, and the carbon fiber weighs in at 62 grams. Both wallets have a thickness of 10.5 millimeters, and that's including the RFID backplate. Just like the Ridge wallet, the brushed black is made from 6061 aluminum, which means it's 4 times stronger than a brick. This type of aluminum is commonly used in the military as well, so this will last you in the harshest environments. The carbon forged wallet is self-explanatory, it's made from pressed carbon fiber. You can fit up to 6 cards in the slot and another 6 cards in this back plate. You can also fit another 3 cards at the front for a total of 15 cards, or you can hold your cash in the front through the rubber band. This wallet features a trigger on the bottom left side, and that fans out your cards in the slot for easy access. One thing I don't like about the wallet is the material of the rubber band. Dust and lint does stick to it easily. And if you're like me who's always losing things, for an extra $39, Ekster has a tracker card that's just as slim as their wallets that you can easily slide in the band. This card is solar powered with only 3 hours of solar charge. This will last you 2 months of use. All you gotta do is down the app and losing your wallet would be a thing in the past. Here's how it looks in my pockets. With a 10.5 millimeter thickness, the outline is very subtle and only slightly noticeable. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For the quality, I'll give it a 10. For its functionality, I'll give it a 9. For its value, I'll give it an 8. That brings the total score to 27. Next wallet I have is from Ekster again, and I promise you this is the last one from Ekster. This is the Parliament Fortuna in Cognac. This is their flagship product and also their most expensive. It retails for $189, but it got on sale for $151. It weighs in at 77 grams and has a thickness of 16¾ millimeters. This wallet is made from extremely soft faux grain leather, which is the highest quality grade of leather that money can buy. This wallet features a foldable flap with two card slots on the inside. On the right side, you'll see the elastic band to hold your cash. On the back, there's a quick access card slot for cards that you use the most. Just like all Ekster wallets, this slot holds up to 6 cards. The trigger feels so smooth, and surprisingly, it feels a lot smoother and easier to press compared to the metal Ekster wallets. Here's how it looks in my pockets. This is the thickest out of all 15 wallets. For a minimalist wallet, this is thicker than I would like, and compared to my traditional wallet, it's about the same thickness, so you'll see more of that outline. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it a 10. For its functionality, I'll give it an 8. For its value, I'll give it an 8. The design and craftsmanship of this wallet is very well done, but $150 is not cheap. That brings the total score to 26. Next wallet is from Rossm. I have 4 different colorways. I have rose gold, forged pacific, forged ember, and carbon fiber. It retails for $30, it weighs in at 62 grams, and has a thickness of about 11 millimeters. The rose gold is made from aluminum, and the other 3 are made from carbon fiber and carbon forged. I love the unique colorway of each wallet, especially the forged ember and pacific. The subtle pop of color really makes this stand out. As you can tell, the design is identical to the Ridge wallet that I talked about earlier, but 70% cheaper. How this wallet works, you simply slip in your cards between the 2 metal plates, and to access your cards, it has a cutout where you push with your thumb, and then you can easily pull your card out. There's an elastic band or money clip to store your cash. This wallet can hold up to 12 cards and 10 cash bills. Rossm provides a money clip and elastic strap with each wallet, which is very generous because Ridge charges you an additional $12 for a clip and $7 for a strap. With this slim profile, you can barely tell that it's in your pants. Overall, at a third of the cost of Ridge wallet, this is definitely an excellent alternative. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it an 8. For its functionality, I'll give it a 9. For its value, I'll give it a 10. Overall, for $30, this wallet would not disappoint. That brings the total score to 27, which ties for the highest rated wallet. Let's see if the next one can top this. Next wallet I have is from Vulkit. It is in a wine colorway and it retails for only $17. It weighs in at 64 grams and has a thickness of 12.5 millimeters. This is basically a budget Ekster wallet. It is made from aluminum, but it doesn't state what kind of aluminum alloy on their website, but it feels like a 1000 series aluminum, which is typically used in metal water bottles and is 3 times weaker than the 6061 aluminum used in the Ekster wallets. This wallet features a trigger that fans out your cards. It holds up to 6 cards in the slot. The trigger isn't as smooth as I like, and you do have to give it a bit of force to activate the trigger. It's also in an awkward position where you need both hands to activate the trigger compared to Ekster wallet where you only use one hand. Wallet also features an elastic pouch where you can keep your cash or your most used cards for quicker access. Here's how the wallet looks in my pocket. With this slim design, it makes this barely noticeable and you can barely feel it. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it a 6. This is made from cheap materials and you can tell right away. For its functionality, I'll give it an 8. For its value, I'll give it a 10. For only $17, do I really need to say more? That brings the total score to 24. Next wallet is from Serman Brands. It is in a Texas brown colorway and it retails for $30. It weighs in at 54 grams and the thickness measures to 14.67 millimeters. According to the website, this wallet is made from bonded leather, which is a mix of top grain, faux grain, and fox leather. I noticed that the material does scratch very easily, but I do like that because it does build character and the material will age beautifully over time. The wallet features a quick access card slot with a push hole for your most used card. On the other side, you see a clear card slot for your ID. On the inside, there's another bonus card slot that you can pull the strap here to access your card. On the other end, there's 2 additional card slots. This wallet can hold a total of 8 cards. In the center is a really cool design that I've never seen before. This is a money clip. All you gotta do is pull this up and slide your bills through, then push this down to secure your cash. Overall, really unique design. Here's how the wallet looks in my pocket. This wallet is the 4th thickest out of 15, so that outline is slightly noticeable, but definitely not as noticeable as a traditional bifold wallet. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it a 7. For its functionality, I'll give it a 10. For its value, I'll give it a 10. That brings the total score to 27, which ties for the highest rated wallet. Let's see if the next one can top this.
Just one quick message before we continue on with this video. If this video is helping you out so far, don't forget to like and subscribe because it really helps out small content creators like myself and it really encourages me to keep putting out videos like this. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and let's get back to the video.
Next wallet is from Vaultskin. This is their Manhattan wallet. The colorway is matte blue and it retails for $36. It weighs in at 36 grams and has a thickness of 6.84 millimeters. This wallet is made from very soft top grain leather and it feels more expensive than its actual price tag. There's one quick access card slot at the front for your most used card. On the inside, there's a total of 4 card slots, 2 on both the right and left side. These card slots can fit 2 cards each for a total of 8 cards. The design of the slot makes it very easy to access all your cards, especially the ones in the back. At the top is a cash pocket that fits US dollars perfectly. If you use British pounds or euros, then you gotta check out their Citi wallet. Since this is a bifold wallet, the thickness is about 7 millimeters, so the outline is slightly noticeable in your pockets, but overall, less noticeable than a traditional bifold wallet. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it a 9. For its functionality, I'll give it a 9. For its value, I'll also give it a 9. Overall, this wallet is beautifully done. The soft texture and minimalist design make this one of my favorite leather wallets. That brings the total score to 27, which ties for the highest rated wallet. Let's see if the next one can top this. Next wallet is from Vaultskin again. The colorway is carmine red and it retails for $27. It weighs in at 21 grams and has a thickness of 5.89 millimeters. The wallet is made from top grain leather and it does feel very soft. The inner material of each card slot features a RFID blocking lining to keep your cards safe. This is an extremely minimalist wallet with only 3 card slots. At the front, it has a vertical card slot and at the back, it has a horizontal card slot. There's also a card slot in the center with a pull tab that allows you to access your card. The wallet can hold up to a total of 8 cards. With this slim profile and soft leather, you can barely tell that anything is in your pants. An extremely simple and straightforward wallet. Now time to give the wallet a rating. For quality, I'll give it an 8. For its functionality, I'll give it an 8. For its value, I'll also give it an 8. That brings the total score to 24. Next wallet is from Fidelo. It is in a black colorway and it retails for $20. It weighs in at 66 grams and has a thickness of 12.8 millimeters. This wallet is made from top grain leather at the top half and nylon on the bottom half. And for the card slot, this is made from 6063 aluminum. First impression, the wallet is very wide. Not sure what the purpose of the wide design is for. The wallet features one card slot at the front and another card slot at the back. If you're not feeling the case, you can easily remove it and just use the card slot. Fidelo also gives you 4 additional elastic straps to hold your cash if you don't want to carry the case. You can hold up to 6 cards in the slot and has a trigger in the bottom to fan out the cards. First impression, the card slot is very uncomfortable to hold in your hands. You can see the edges are not chamfered or rounded, leaving a sharp edge. Because of that, I will keep it in the case at all times. The trigger is a bit stiff, but it does its job. Here's how the wallet looks in my pocket. Because of its wide and hard construction, the outline is very noticeable. Time to give this wallet a rating. For the quality, I'll give it a 7. For its functionality, I'll give it a 7. For its value, I'll give it an 8. That brings the total score to 22, making this the lowest scoring wallet so far. Let's see if the next one's any better. Next wallet is from Travando. The colorway is carbon and it retails for $24. It weighs in at 66 grams and has a thickness of 14.7 millimeters. The material is made from fox leather, so it feels straight up like plastic. On the outside, it has one card slot with a push show at the bottom that allows you to easily access your cards. On the inside, it has a total of 10 card slots, 5 on the left side and 5 on the right side. With this 11 card slots, this wallet can easily hold over 20 cards, and I'm sure I'm not the only one that thinks this is an overkill. On the right side, there's a metal money clip. Rather than a traditional pouch to store your cash, this money clip will keep your wallet slim. This wallet is a bit thick, so the outline of your pants is pretty noticeable. The size of this wallet is about the same as my traditional wallet. Now time to rate this wallet. For its quality, I'll give it a 6. The wallet feels extremely cheap. For its functionality, I'll give it a 7. For its value, I'll give it a 6. $25 is not a lot, but it feels like a $10 wallet. That brings the total score to 19. Next wallet I have is from Zitahli. This is in a carbon black brown colorway. It retails for $25. It weighs in at 66 grams and thickness of 13.4 millimeters. This wallet looks nearly identical to the Travando wallet that I just talked about earlier. That just shows that a lot of sellers on Amazon are dropshipping using the same factories from China but just rebranded. It is made from the same cheap fox leather. I do like the brown accent to make this wallet stand out. It has two card slots in the front and a push hole for quick access. On the inside, it has a total of 5 card slots on both right and left side for a total of 10 slots. There's also a money clip on the right side. Here's a shot of how it looks in my chinos. This wallet is a bit thick, so the outline of your pants is pretty noticeable. The size of the wallet is about the same as my traditional wallet. The time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it a 5. The wallet feels really bad and you can quickly tell that this is made from very cheap material. For its functionality, I'll give it a 7. For its value, I'll give it a 6. That brings the total score to 18, making this the lowest rated wallet so far. Let's see if the next one's any better. Next wallet I have is from Travelambo. This is in a khaki deep colorway. It retails for $10. It weighs in at 19 grams and thickness of about 4.6 millimeters. This wallet is made from 100% cowhide leather, which is very surprising considering how affordable this wallet is. It has a total of 7 card slots. There's one see-through card slot for your ID. On the back, there's 3 more vertical card slots, and it has 3 pouch style slots for your cards or cash. Here's how it looks in my pockets. This leather material on the wallet does feel great. It's lightweight, thin, and a simple wallet that does its job. Now time to rate this wallet. For its quality, I'll give it an 8. For its functionality, I'll give it an 8. For its value, I'll give it a 9. That brings the total score to 25. Next wallet is from Nomatic, and this is their V2 model. The colorway is gray and it retails for $20. It weighs in at 15 grams and has a thickness of 9.2 millimeters. 99% of this wallet is made from elastic except for the pull tab, which is leather. This wallet reminds me of a sock, but for your cards. The main compartment can hold up to 15 cards. The cool thing about this design is that when you pull out your cards with the tab, the stretchy material allows you to fan out your cards to easily pick the one that you need. The wallet also has a hidden pocket where you can store your cash or coins. Here's how it looks in my pockets. Because of the material and thin profile, you can hardly feel or tell that's in your pocket. A time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I'll give it an 8. For its functionality, I'll give it an 8. For its value, I'll give it a 9. That brings the total score to 25. Next wallet is from Muradin. This is in a Saffiano blue colorway. It retails for $30. It weighs in at 84 grams and has a thickness of 16.92 millimeters. The wallet is made from a top grain leather on the outside, and on the inside, there's a leather card slot and an aluminum frame. There's one card slot on the outside for quick access. Right away, I noticed the leather is very stiff and takes a bit of force to slide your cards in and out. On the other side is even worse because it features 10 screws to hold together the card slot, and you really need to push your card in with all your force. I assume this will soften up over time, but honestly, I really don't want to deal with that. This card slot is literally unusable. On the inside, there's a card slot for your ID, and this is also pretty stiff, but not as bad. On the other side, you have an aluminum frame to hold your cards. This frame has spring tabs on the side where it depresses when you slide your card in, and then springs back forward to lock your card in place. This cutout on the frame allows you to store some cash behind your cards. Overall, it can hold up 12 cards and 5 bills. It also comes with an elastic band that you can slide onto your wallet, but honestly, I think this band is useless and doesn't really serve a purpose. Here's how it looks in my pockets. This is the thickest out of all 15 wallets. For a minimalist wallet, this is thicker than I would like, and compared to my traditional wallet, it's about the same thickness, so you'll see more of that outline. Now time to rate this wallet. For its quality, I give it an 8. For its functionality, I give it a 6. For its value, I give it a 7. That brings the total score to 21. And the last wallet I have is from Buffway. The colorway is called Alaska Brown. It retails for $15. It weighs in at 23 grams and thickness of about 4.34 millimeters. This wallet is made from 100% leather with a polyester lining. This leather feels very plastic. I'm having a hard time believing this is real leather, but then again, for $15, can't really expect much. This wallet is very similar to the Travelambo wallet from earlier. It has a total of 8 card slots. At the front, it has one see-through card slot for your ID, another slot at the top, and one vertical slot. On the other side, there's 3 horizontal card slots and 1 vertical card slot. There's a push hole for quick access for your most used card. At the center is a pouch style card slot that you can store more cards or cash. Here's how it looks in my pockets. This is a lightweight and simple wallet that does its job. Now time to give this wallet a rating. For its quality, I give it a 7. For its functionality, I give it an 8. For its value, I give it an 8. That brings the total score to 23. Tallying up the final scores, here are the top 5 best slim wallets on the market today. Serman Brands, Rossm, Vaultskin, Ekster, and Simply Carbon Fiber. If you're looking for a wallet that has the best functionality and value, then Serman Brands is the winner. This is my favorite design wallet. It has all the features that you need while still maintaining a slim and minimalist design. If you're looking for a metal wallet with the best value, then Rossm is the winner. For only $30, you get a beautifully made wallet with sleek designs. The money clip and elastic that comes with each wallet makes this wallet even more worth it. If you're looking for an extremely lightweight and minimal wallet, then Simply Carbon Fiber is a winner. I'm still amazed at how this wallet is made from just a single piece of carbon fiber. The design is so minimalistic, yet it can still hold so much. If you're looking for the highest quality wallet, then Ekster is a winner. The quality and craftsmanship is by far the best out of all wallets. The trigger that fans out your cards is so well done, and the overall design of this wallet will not disappoint. If you're looking for the best all-around wallet that checks all the boxes, then Vaultskin Manhattan is a winner. This wallet has incredible leather quality considering its low price tag. The design is so simple yet does everything you need it to do. To summarize, here are my top 5 favorite wallets that you can't go wrong with any. Here are my next 6 favorite wallets. And here are the bottom rank wallets that I was very disappointed with.
And that's it for this week's video. Let me know in the comments below which is your favorite wallet. And if you love minimal wallets but you're on a budget, click right here to check out my video on the best and worst minimalist wallets. So that's it for this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.